I've never once done a cold culture restaurant. I don't just walk in. You guys know this is the back of people. Like, you walk in, you have your little, you know, I call them little security guards, your little hostess or managers. Like, oh yeah, chef's not here. Yeah, can I talk to you, guy? You know, he's like, no, I'm done. I've been here for 8 hours, dude. It's noon. I don't want to talk to anybody. That's the reality.
Yeah.
So, but we go in there, and now obviously sometimes it works and they don't mind seeing you, but it's really quite funny because I don't want to cut product, deliver, and all of a sudden I can't actually sit down with the person making the purchasing decision, the chef, Sue, whoever it might be, right? So I preset every meeting I've ever done. One, I just respect the time. I respect my time and I respect their time. When I first began, I worked 8 to 5. I didn't have that 2 p.m. window to go down and talk to a chef. So on my one day off, which I did as a Monday, I just hammered out meetings. So I booked everything within, you know, a 2 hour window and just went boom, 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 just hammered them out, right? But I preset them. I valued my time, but also I don't want a bunch of waste. I don't want to cut product. I show up and no one's there. Or even worse, you get in the awkward situation with like, oh yeah, I'll just give it a chef. That doesn't go anywhere. It sits on the bar for 3 hours and they wonder why it's mushy microgreens.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Or they put it under the heat lamp, right? It's funny, but part of me when I talk about selling, and we were not talking about that today, but when I talk about selling, it's not about the product. It sells itself. For me, it's about me, my farm, how I'm different than the large providers, the large distributors. How do we bring value to you? That can't be showcased by, hey, here's some product. They'll be, oh, super, more pea shoots. Great, I'll use them. It's free, yay. Save me some food costs, right? And they don't ever call you back, right? So for me, Instagram was a way when I reached out to chefs or reached out to grocers or whoever it might be, inevitably, they're probably going to come back and look at my Instagram. So I cultivated an Instagram that was very showcased around product, farm product, right? And for you guys, you have a great model where, hey, here's how to use it. So if you're looking at getting more on the culinary side, then you could kind of even do, you know, very intentional where, okay, we're going to do a food post, we're going to do a menu post, we're going to do a commercial post, whatever it might be, right?
Yeah.
So look at so many Instagrams are very unique, right? Because they're very, you know, one will be like a picture, then a quote, then a picture, right? Whatever it is, right? So this is what Instagram for me needs to be very intentional. So often as micro farmers, we just post stuff. Ooh, there's my kid eating microgreens. I'm going to post that. I don't know if a chef wants to see that. I see one guy's where I saw like cat litter boxes under pea shoots. Like it's just, it's not a business model, right? But we so often just want to post a picture. So you want to be intentional about your posts. That's what it comes down to. For me, if I'm coming from a third party perspective, if I'm looking at Instagram, like, ooh, I want to buy from there, right? That's how we did it. Appearance is reality, right? They look like, ooh, I don't know that. Like there's always, when we moved out of our basement, we actually told some people, some chefs like, really? You're in a basement? Like, yep, you couldn't tell. Because we did, you know, we had obviously in a basement, we had poly. So what I did painter's drop sheets. So it's a nice little beige back wall. Guess what? Can't tell I'm in a basement. I did 2 years of very intentional pictures. Well, you can never see how I hung it, right? But it was a basement. Now, there's nothing wrong with being a basement. It's all legal. It's all up and up.
Yeah.
But appearance is reality. Ooh, I'm getting microgreens from a basement. A lot of people just, we feel bad about it, right? It's like the old saying, people feel bad about buying jewelry from Costco. I'm like, yeah, well, they're also some of the best jewelry. You don't need to spend, you know, on someone's commission to buy from the high-end jewelry place, right? It's the same premise here. I was able to keep my costs down. I was able to be sustainable in a basement for 2 years nearly, and be very competitive in the marketplace. And that allowed us as a platform to transition out to a commercial facility. But if I'm doing, oh, I got to get the best of everything and all this, it's going to be tough to do, right? Yeah. For me, this business is just moving forward in that accordance. Point being is you can do that, but you can still have a beautiful looking Instagram, right? So I use that as a platform for reaching out. So as such, I cultivated Instagram that was very intentional. And that was the key for me. Every picture was intentional. And a great way to do it too is, you know, this is good. This day is your farm where everything looks nice and full and green. Take 30 pictures that day. It's amazing how many different ways you can take a picture of a pea shoot. This day is, oh yeah, peas are good. This way, it's amazing.